Hi, my name is David, and in today's video we're going to show you how to use the Ghost Textile ICC profile. I've made a previous video, which you can find in the info box below, on how to install the profile on your Mac and on some general information about ICC profiling. But today's video, we're going to print the same design, one design using the profile and one design without using the profile. And we're going to transfer these designs with Ghost Sublime Toner to these polyester sheets, and we're going to compare the results and see what difference it makes to use an ICC profile or not to. All right, but before we start, I'm going to check if I have the Ghost Sublime Toner cartridges inside my printer. So I open the printer, I just check if I have the Sublime Toners inside, that's correct. And I close the printer again. And I'm also checking if I have regular standard copy paper inside the printer. That's correct as well, because with Ghost Sublime Toner, you just use standard copy paper for your transfers. All right, so on my screen, I have my design. For this test, we're choosing a multicolor design with lots of photography images, with some vector artwork in the middle, and these different images cover a huge range of like halftones, face tones, skin tones, which will show the difference of using the profile or not. All right, so I open the print dialog and I make my settings. The first print I'm going to run with the profile, and the second print I'm going to run without using the profile. All right, so for the layout setting, the image is already set to mirror image mode, which is important as we're transferring directly from the paper. And for color matching, I choose color sync inside the driver, and I choose the Ghost Textile ICC profile. You could use any other profile here, or you can have it set to automatic, but as we want to use this specific profile, we just tell the printer. And then we hit the print button. All right, so that first print will be the print where we are using the profile, and I'm going to write down ICC on the backside of the paper so that we can identify it through the whole process. That's the print, and I write ICC on the backside with a pen. Okay, and the second print, I'm just going to run it straight again. Print job, mirror image mode is still the same, of course, and for color matching this time, I choose in printer. So basically, there's no color matching, no profiling, no color management from the software, from the computer, but the printer is just using a standard LaserJet printer profile. By the way, you can use Ghost Sublime Toner without the profile at any time, especially for all kinds of vector artworks and graphics or typography. These kinds of design work fantastic without any profiling, especially if you're doing single color designs on mugs or on other hard surfaces like keyrings and stuff. It's super easy to do that without profiling. But when it comes to photography images and skin tones, the profile does make a lot of sense. So I hit print and wait for my print to be printed. I'm going to write nothing on the back this case so we can easily identify these two prints. Cool. If you would compare the images, you can already tell a little difference, but it looks pretty similar, so we will see what we get. So we go over to the heat press. The heat press is preheated to 200 degrees, and I'm going to place two polyester fabrics, identical type of fabric, on the bottom plate. Careful not to burn my fingers. And I'm going to use the file which was printed without the profile on the bottom one, and the one that is marked ICC on the top one. That doesn't make a big difference because this is a good heat press. It's very accurate temperature and pressure all the way. And I'm pressing these two together for 60 seconds at 200 degrees. So the time's almost up. I open the heat press and let's see what we got. I quickly start peeling. I start with the one without the profile, and then I peel the profile one. These few seconds in time difference doesn't make a big difference. So when we take a look at the peeled papers, which are actually trash, we're not going to use them a second time, we can see that the color has been taken off. There's a slight difference. So this one is a bit darker, I would say, than this one. This one actually is the ICC one, and this one is the no profile one. But let's take a look at the actual fabrics, because this is where we can see a really big difference. So take a look at this one first. All right, you can see there's a lot of contrast in the images, especially here in the skin tones. It's really, really dark. Same down here in the skin tones. There's almost no distinguishing between the contrast and the halftones. So this is really, really dark. This was the one printed without the ICC profile. I'm going to put this down here for our reference. And this is the one printed with the ICC profile. I would say we can already tell a little difference up here. It's much brighter, skin tones are much more lighter, and especially down here, we've got proper contrast, we've got proper distinguishing between the halftones. And if we take a look at these images in close-up, we can really tell a difference. If we, you know, put them like this, we can really, really tell a difference between this image and that image, and of course, this image and that image. The next step, what we're going to do is we're going to take both and compare them. So the upper one is the ICC one to the actual screen display. And this is where you really can see a difference. ICC one and the non-ICC one, all right? If you take a look, the tones are really off from the screen. So especially the child up here, it's really dark. It looks like a bad Instagram filter to me. Also down below, the contrast is completely lost in the blacks. But if we would use the ICC profile one, you can really see that we've got almost a perfect match up with the screen contrast in all four images, as different as they are. And this is why we suggest that for printing onto fabrics or any kind of sublimation friendly blanks, using when you want to print photographic images, especially faces, portraits, you know, family pictures, skin tones. If you have images like this, we really suggest you to use the ICC profile. As you can see, it's super easy, it's super convenient, doesn't make a lot of a difference in your printer settings, but it makes a lot of a difference in the final result when it comes to printing these designs. All right, that's it for today. If you have any questions about ICC profiling, please check out our other videos on the channel or leave us a comment below. Also, if you have other questions or ideas for future videos, please put that in the comments as well. Give us a thumbs up if you like the ICC profile and the effect it has on the actual final result. Follow the channel for future updates. Thanks for watching. See you next time.